Then I will come to order. I ask all present to please rise and join with me as we recite the Pledge of Allegiance to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. In the absence of clergy, I ask all to bow our heads in a moment of silent reflection and prayer. Reading of the journal.
In Senate Wednesday, May 30th, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Tuesday, May 29th, was read and approved on motion. Senate adjourned.
Without objection, journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. The Secretary will read.
On page 39, Senator Bonasek moves to discharge from the Committee on Judiciary Assembly Bill number 9400 and substitute for the identical Senate Bill number 6624. Third reading calendar 787.
Substitution so ordered.
On page 39, Senator Hannah moves to discharge from the Committee on Judiciary Assembly Bill number 9836 and substitute the identical Senate Bill number 6977, third reading calendar 790.
Substitution so ordered.
On page 41, Senator Hannah moves to discharge from the Committee on Health Assembly Bill number 9901 and substitute the identical Senate Bill number 6972, third reading calendar 818.
And the substitution is so ordered.
And on page 48, Senator Diaz moves to discharge from the Committee on Energy and Telecommunications Assembly Bill number 759A and substitute the identical Senate Bill number 502A, third reading calendar 964.
Substitution is so ordered. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees. Communications and reports from state officers. Motions and resolutions, Senator Lavelle.
Mr. President, on page 16, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 289, Senate print number 5641, and ask that said bill retain its place on third reading calendar.
The amendments are received and the bill shall retain its place on third reading.
Mr. President, on page 26, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 594, Senate print number 6268B. And ask that said bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
The amendments are received and the bill shall retain its place on third reading. Senator Lavelle.
May we please adopt the resolution calendar with the exception of resolution 4963.
All in favor of adopting the resolution calendar with the exception of resolution number 4963, signify by saying aye. Opposed? The resolution calendar is adopted. Senator Lavelle.
By Senator Little at the desk, number 4963, I ask that it be read in its entirety and then call on Senator Little.
The Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 4963, memorializing Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim May 31 through June 6, 2012. As Museum Week in the state of New York. Whereas the state of New York takes great pride in participating in special days of recognition for its esteemed institutions. And whereas attendant to such concern in full accord with its long-standing traditions is the sense of this legislative body to memorialize Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim May 31 through June 6, 2012 as Museum Week in the state of New York. And whereas on this most auspicious occasion, New York State is celebrating the diversity and richness of its museums by inviting residents and visitors alike to discover the fascinating worlds of art, photography, history, science, pop culture, and more. And whereas from May 31 through June 6, 2012, more than 200 museums across the state will be part of the inaugural New York State Museum Week, and we'll be offering special events, activities, and promotions to give guests a sample of the exhibitions and programs available at the nearly 2,000 museums located throughout New York. And whereas New York's diverse array of museums, historic homes, zoos, and botanical gardens offer something for everyone and every family. And whereas Museum Week will highlight the wide array of educational, cultural, and historic attractions that are available throughout the state of New York and visitors from around the world. And whereas the participating organizations and institutions located in every part of New York State are not only vital cultural resources for our state, they are also important economic engines for their communities. And whereas from ancient treasures to the I Love Lucy soundstage, Museum Week offers New Yorkers and travelers from around the world an opportunity to visit what is collectively the most impressive and unique cultural experiences anywhere to be found. And whereas our museums celebrate and preserve our historic and cultural heritage, as well as enrich our communities and play a vital role in the state's economy. And whereas the legislative body takes pleasure in celebrating Museum Week, recognizing the important and unique role our museums play in education, tourism, and community development for our cities, towns, and villages throughout this great empire state. Now, therefore, be it resolved that this legislative body pauses its deliberations to memorialize Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim May 31 through June 6, 2012, as Museum Week in the state of New York, and be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution, suitably engrossed, be transmitted to the Honorable Andrew M. Cuomo, Governor of the state of New York.
Senator Little.
Thank you, Mr. President. First of all, I'd like to begin by thanking Governor Cuomo for proclaiming this as the first ever New York State Museum Week, which I think is going to kick off our summer tourist season and help all of us to recognize the small museums and the large museums that exist in our district. I'd also like to thank I Love New York for participating, for developing a website, for really working with us, and in particular Kelly Rabideau of I Love New York for her efforts in this. Also, the Executive Director of the New York State Association of Museums, Ann Ackerson, for her participation. I'd also like to thank my colleagues for participating and for recognizing your museums that are in your district. I know we have sent out a blast email to many of the people that we email telling them about it. I also have a kickoff event this afternoon at the Hyde Museum, which is located in Glens Falls, and we'll be attending and looking at the other museums throughout the week. This is an opportunity for our wonderful New York State museums, historic sites, botanical gardens and those things, to celebrate their existence and to offer specials, promotions, and get people interested. As we begin the summer season and make our travel plans, we would be encouraging people to not only think of where they're going to vacation, but to look in their own backyard for activities and things that they can do there, and particularly by visiting a museum. And visiting a museum this week that's participating is very special, and it also gives a taste of what is there, from Slate Museum that I have in Granville to larger museums that we have in the Plattsburgh area, the Olympic Museum in Lake Placid. We have so many places and so many things, and so many of our small museums do not have the budget and the money to market themselves. So I believe that having this first ever New York State Museum Week will help call attention to these wonderful resources in New York State, and I thank all of you for participating and making this a special week. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Little. Senator Serrano.
Thank you, Mr. President, and I want to convey my gratitude to the Chair of the Cultural Affairs Committee, Senator Little, and thank her for her leadership and I Love New York and all of the agencies involved with Museum Week. And as Senator Little mentioned, this is a wonderful opportunity to showcase all the wonderful cultural venues that we have throughout our state, especially our museums, and with a firm understanding that the economic engine, one of the main economic engines in New York State, is our tourism sector, as well as our cultural and entertainment sector. We see every day what museums and cultural institutions do for New York City. It's obvious to anyone who knows the city that New York would not be the amazing city that it is had it not been for the cultural venues that attract tourists from all over the world and bring in dollars from all over the world. So I think it's important that on a state level we showcase all of the wonders that we have. We have so much to offer on a state level, and this will give museums a wonderful opportunity to draw in patrons, to learn. The educational opportunities are endless. And once again, I applaud Senator Little for her leadership on this. Thank you very much.
Senator Farley.
Yes, I rise to support Senator Little's resolution in that, you know, museums in New York State, we are a wealth source of history and art. And in my own district, I have seven or eight that are participating in this, and it is a tremendous tourist attraction. It is tremendous for, particularly for upstate New York, which needs the revenue and the tourism. But these museums are a wonderful wealth source in this state, and it's something that we can be very proud of. And it's something that that Senator Little, in her resolution, and the governor for promoting our museums around the state. And I think it's a very exciting week that is coming up, and I hope that everybody participates. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Farley. Senator Little.
President, I was remiss in saying that I would hope and everyone would be interested in being on this museum resolution. We open it up to all the members of the Senate, and hope you'll participate. Thank you.
At the sponsor's request, the resolution will be open for co-sponsorship. If you choose not to be a co-sponsor, notify the desk. Question is on the resolution. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The resolution is adopted. Senator Lavelle.
Mr. President, may we please have the non-controversial reading of the calendar.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 729 by Senator Nozzolio, Senate Print 4512A, enact amend the retirement Social Security law.
Last section. Lay it aside for the day.
Calendar number 742 by Senator Nozzolio, Senate Print 7021A, enact amend the public authorities law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act will take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 53.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 745 by Senator Maziar, Senate Print 7327, enact amend the public authorities law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act will take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 53.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 748 by Senator Hannon, Senate Print 7243, enact amend the civil service law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin.
Senator Little to explain her vote.
Thank you. I am a no vote on this bill, and it sounds like a horrible thing to be doing. However, as a member of the Mandate Relief Council, this is a mandate that I think that we should not be passing at this time. So thank you.
Senator Little to be recorded in the negative. Announce the results.
I think Richie's done.
Ayes 50, nays 3. Senators Little, O'Mara, and Richie recorded in the negative.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 750 by Senator Young, Senate Print 773, enact amend the agriculture markets law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act will take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 53.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 764. Calendar number 764 by Senator Maziar, Senate Print 518, enact amend the penal law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin.
Just pause for a
Ayes 53.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 770 by Senator Bonasik, Senate Print 6426, enact amend the Alcoholic Beverage
Last
Control
section.
Law. Section 4 of this has to take effect on the 180th day.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 52, nays 1. Senator Fuchillo recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 772 by Senator Farley, Senate Print 6770, an act to authorize.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 52, nays 1. Senator Fuchillo recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 773 by Senator Larkin, Senate Print 6986, enact amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 53, nays 1. Senator Fuchillo recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 778 by Senator Oppenheimer, Senate Print 6290, enacting relation.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 779 by Senator Ritchie, Senate Print 7138, enact amending the vehicle and traffic law.
Last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 783 by Senator Roback, Senate Print 490, enact amended domestic relations law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 787 by member of the Assembly Weinstein, Assembly Print 9400, enact amend Chapter 363 of the laws of 2010.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 790 by member of the Assembly, Abinanti, Assembly Print 9836, enact to amend the Surrogate Courts Procedure Act.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 792 by Senator Maziar, Senate Print 3203B, enact amend the tax law.
Last section.
Section 4, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 799 by Senator Farley, Senate Print 5129, enact amend the state finance law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 180th day.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 818 by member of the Assembly, Tatone, Assembly Print 9901, enact amend the public health law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 832 by Senator Marcelino, Senate Print 6999A, enact to authorize.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 51, nays 3. Senators Bonasek, Larkin, and O'Mara recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 842 by Senator Seward, Senate Print 6978, enact amend the insurance law.
Last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect immediately.
Call roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 53, nays 1. Senator Peralta recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 871 by Senator Lanza, Senate Print 2937A, enact amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 964 by member of the Assembly Dinowitz, Assembly Print 759A, enact amend the elder law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 965 by Senator Kennedy, Senate Print 4726, enact amend the penal law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes.
Senator Kennedy to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to thank my colleagues for their support on this important piece of legislation today. This legislation will make criminal impersonation of a disabled veteran vendor a Class A misdemeanor. When someone impersonates a disabled veteran vendor for personal gain, they're committing a truly shameful act. Once this becomes law, the legislation will ensure this reprehensible act becomes a punishable crime. Not only does impersonation of a disabled veteran vendor deceive the buying public, it also inflicts serious economic pain upon actual disabled veteran vendors. This deception results in the theft of business that rightfully belongs to men and women who made great sacrifices in service to this country. People often make the conscious decision to purchase goods or services from a disabled veteran-owned business. Impersonating a disabled veteran vendor deprives veterans of an economic benefit they earned after protecting our freedoms. Making the impersonation of a veteran vendor a Class A misdemeanor will establish a deterrent to this criminal activity, and it will ensure law enforcement has the tools to crack down on anyone who impersonates a disabled veteran business owner. It will stop people who try to cheat the system and steal from veterans. With this bill, offenders who defraud the public by pretending to be disabled veteran vendors can be punished with up to 1 year in prison. This legislation will set the precedent that in New York State, you won't get away with defrauding veterans out of benefits that they've earned. We must do all we can to protect our veterans, and this legislation is an important next step. Under this bill, we will stand up and stop those who impersonate veteran-owned businesses in attempts to deceive their way into stealing businesses from veterans who gave so much for our state and our nation. Thank you, Mr. President. I vote aye.
Senator Kennedy, to be recorded in the affirmative, announce the results.
Ayes 52, nays 2. Senators Montgomery and Perkins recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 967 by Senator Diaz, Senate Print 6237, Act amend the corrections law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act to take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 54.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 968 by Senator Peralta, Senate Print 6292, enact amend the penal law.
Last section.
Section 8, this act shall take effect on the 1st of November.
Call roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin.
Senator Peralta to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to thank all my colleagues for voting on this bill today. As you know, a terrorist plot to do us harm might not be hatched in another country thousands of miles from here. That may be hatched, but some of the tools to make it happen are being produced right here in our own backyard. Actually, they're being produced in my backyard more than in anyone else's. The stretch of Roosevelt Avenue in my district from about 75th Street up to 103rd Street has been identified by investigators as the East Coast epicenter of fake ID production and sale. Forged documents available on Roosevelt Avenue include driver's licenses, passports, and Social Security cards. They're believed to be 10 or more mills churning out these forgeries. But it is not simply a matter of quantity, but of quality as well. And it is the quality of these forged documents, coupled with the fact that they are so easy to obtain, that undermines the hard work of Homeland Security and law enforcement to keep us safe. Given the quality of these forged official documents and their ready availability on Roosevelt Avenue and elsewhere, it should come as no surprise that we're seeing fake IDs at the heart of a number of criminal enterprises, scandals, and tragedies, from identity theft to college entrance exams to deaths on our roadways. The fake ID and forgery business has been thriving on Roosevelt Avenue for many, many years. The Queens District Attorney, Richard Brown, has worked very hard on this issue for years. I approached DA Brown and asked him how I could help, and we came up with this piece of legislation. Under this bill, the manufacture and sale of a false document would be upgraded from a Class D to a Class C felony, roughly doubling jail sentences. It would also make forging an ID a more serious offense than other forgeries, say of a MetroCard, for example. Penalties for possessing a fake ID or other false document would remain the same. That's important to keep in mind because as things stand today, an underage drinker caught with a fake ID potentially faces the same punishment under the law as someone running a fake ID mill. Simply put, this bill very specifically and directly singles out the real threats to society. It does that by defining sale in a way that helps police and prosecutors target every link in the chain of sale, making it more difficult for forged document rings to operate whether on Roosevelt Avenue or any place in New York State. So I want to thank my colleagues for voting yay on this piece of legislation.
Senator Peralta to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 53, nays 1. Senator Duane recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 971 by Senator Roback, Senate Print 7490, enact amend Chapter 557 of the laws of 2001.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 53, nays 2. Senators Duane and Gallivan recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed. Senator Libous, that completes the reading of the non-controversial calendar.
Could we please go back to motions, please?
We're back to motions.
On behalf of Senator Ranzenhofer, on page 13, I offer the following amendments on calendar number 140, Senate print 5198C, and ask that said bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
The amendments are received, and the bill shall retain its place on third reading.
Again, on behalf of Senator Ranzenhofer, on page 26, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 564, Senate print 6614, ask that said bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
The amendments are received, and the bill shall retain its place on third reading.
Mr. President, is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business.
Mr. President, I have an announcement. There will be a meeting of the Crime Victims, Crime and Corrections Committee immediately following session in room 124.
Meeting in room 124 immediately following session of the Crime Victims and Crime and Corrections Committee.
Mr. President, there being no further business, I move we adjourn until Monday, June 4th at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Monday, June 4th at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days. Senate adjourned.